everybody this fine day? Thanks for tuning in for another episode of the No No Show. We're sitting here this evening with a special guest and someone actually we've been looking forward to having on the show, Mr. Richard Sutton, also known as Mr. PDQ. How you doing, sir?
Oh man, it's a pleasure. I appreciate the opportunity.
Oh man, we're blessed to have you on. Oh man, and this is, you know how No Notes is. This is what we do, man. We bring the people out there to you, so you know who's out there, who's available, who's doing their thing out there in the world, and who maybe can be a benefit to you as well, as you hear their skill set. So without further ado, we're going to get right into it. So please, first, how was your day today?
My day been hectic, man. I spoke at a middle school up in the further northeast. Okay. Left there, went and had a meeting with my aunt and uncle. Okay. Left there, got here to be in your presence, be on the awesome the No No Show. You know what I'm saying?
Thank you. Yeah,
this opportunity to talk about, you know, honored to have me on. I'm honored to be on here because you guys are doing awesome. You know, just going through. Looking at your video clips on YouTube and checking out your website, and you know, I still be struggling trying to sign the West name, so I gotta get that straight. But anything with us doing us and supporting us, I'm all for it.
Yeah, and we certainly appreciate that. And again, and you just heard it, I mean, a man that's on the run, on the go, you know, moving and shaking, and that's what we love to see. And this is what this is about, you know, we as a people supporting each other, very important. So, speaking of in terms of helping the people, tell us a little about what you do. You're according to the website, and he has a great website. We want you to go check it out, and we'll talk about that in a little bit, share that information as well. But you speak to that on your website. You're an inspirational speaker that speaks to adult and youth alike, mm-hmm. And you're putting them on a right financial path, a right career path, their educational goals. You're helping them really drive, you know, get to what they're passionate about, and making people understand the importance of finance and education and how to move forward. So tell us a little bit about that.
Well, my background is banking. I was in banking for a little over 10 years. I was a banker, I was a branch manager. So I've seen the ups and downs, the pitfalls of managing a bank mm-hmm. in a less productive neighborhood, and managing a bank in the upper echelon parts of the city as well. Okay. So I've seen the disparities in how we our relationship with finance. And so you have a lot of people out here that speak about finance, but there's very few people that speak about understanding the basics, the nuts and bolts of how to start from here, mm-hmm. and then we get you there. And that's my lane. I want to teach you how to talk about paying yourself first, your relationship with your money. You know, right now, I'm actually about to do a YouTube video this Saturday called Why Not Prosper 2016.
Okay.
And what I'm going to talk about is put away your bank card and have the relationship with your money again.
Okay.
So that's one of the things.
That sounds very interesting.
Yeah.
That sounds very interesting.
One of the things you got to touch on, I feel like we don't have a relationship with our money no more, and the banks are making a killing off of us with overdraft fees and stuff mm-hmm. like that because we don't have a relationship.
So. Right. And I guess, and that goes along with, you know, being knowledgeable of how that works, how your money can work for you.
Yeah, exactly.
That's awesome. So, when you go out to schools and speak to children, what's that? Tell us that about the experience. I mean, because that's a wonderful thing. I mean, reaching out to the youth, you know, helping them get, you know, guiding them, putting them on the right track.
I'm super passionate about talking to the youth because I feel like one thing I know about young people is this. Mm-hmm. If you phony, they know. Without question, if they feel like you giving them a bad bill of beans, they're gonna let you know.
They're gonna call you.
They are the most honest, brutally honest group of people you can speak to. And so I love talking to them because I'm passionate about seeing them be in good places that I wasn't afforded when I was in school. No one came and talked to us about our money or just being motivated as a whole. You know, I call myself an inspirational speaker, not a motivational speaker, because I can motivate you for a couple of minutes, mm-hmm. and then when you walk out the door, mm-hmm. it's done. Right?
Right.
But if I inspire you,
then that's going to last.
when you walk out the door, you're going to be more inclined to move on that inspiration versus being motivated.
Okay.
So if I can inspire you to motivate you to be inspired to go do what you need to do and what you want to do, then we made a move. And, okay. And anytime I talk to kids or adults, or like, to be honest with you though, my only focus is if I can reach one person. If I touch more than one,
that's wonderful.
Wonderful.
Right.
But my goal is if I can touch one person, because that one person can touch another person, which can touch another person, then we start a ripple effect. But I don't go in there with the mindset that I'm going to bless everybody. I go in there if I could just reach one person.
Right.
But if I get everybody,
that's an
awesome job.
So with that, I mean, what kind of feedback do you get from the youth, from the adults alike? I mean, once you do a presentation after you're done, what are some of the things that you're getting back in terms of how they liked your presentation?
Funny you ask that. I spoke at Gratz a couple weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
My good friend Michelle Snow.
Yes.
Asked me. Michelle.
Michelle.
She asked me to come. She said, Rich, I want you to come down to Gratz and speak or whatever. So, you know, and she and I was on the same team in the same, you know, in the same room speaking to the same kids.
Mm-hmm.
And it was an awesome panel. I was up there amongst some really, really good people.
Mm-hmm.
And when I spoke to the kids, I actually had to go when I got done. And when I got done, the teacher handed me this card.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm rushing, so I don't see it. I throw it in my jacket.
Okay.
I keep it moving. Okay. But I'm exhausted when I left because I gave them everything. And, and that's when I knew, like, this is what I'm supposed to be doing. Because when I can give you everything, then I know I'm passionate about where I'm at with this. And about a week or two later, I'm taking the clothes to the cleaners, and I go and I find that card. And on the card, they was rating everybody that came in because it was a career day.
Okay.
And so on the card, they wrote very inspirational.
Okay.
And I'm looking at the card.
That's nice.
I just kind of looked up and said, God, you're funny. You funny guy, you know.
Uh-huh.
So and I took it and I put it in my mirror.
Right.
And so it was cool. Then last week I went up. Last week I spoke up in the far northeast, and it was my first time speaking to a predominantly all Caucasian group of kids.
Okay.
And I kind of got nervous. Like, am I going to be able to relate to them?
Okay.
Stupid. Okay. It was a stupid thought.
Right.
I had to say to myself, be you, do you. You'll be fine. Mm-hmm. I spoke to them.
Mm-hmm.
When I got done, I was about to leave, and the kids turned around and said, Mr. Sutton, can you come back and teach us? So that's why I was back there today.
Mm-hmm.
And it blew my mind, but it taught me a lesson at the same time. So that's why I like to talk to kids, because sometimes I think we let the perpetuation of what media and the stereotypes and the propaganda that we get fed on a day-to-day basis to kind of miss our judgment on how we interact with people.
Okay.
And what kids, to me, always teach you is at the end of the day,
mm-hmm.
we're all just people.
Yes.
That's it. Right?
Yeah, how powerful is that?
And skin color means nothing.
Right.
Because I gave them what I gave Gratz.
Right.
And I got the same result.
Right.
So I didn't have to alter who I was, change who I was, or try to make it different for them.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to feed you the same thing how I fed them, because I'm passionate about what I do.
Good.
So, and it paid off.
Now, are you originally from Philadelphia? Or are you
born and raised.
Born and raised in Philadelphia.
Born and raised.
Tell us a little bit about your family. And with that, a little bit about your, when you were coming up, your educational background.
Well, I grew up in Germantown.
Okay.
Spent my teenage years in Wessel Lane. Mm-hmm. I went to, and it's funny, you know what, because all my schools are closed. I take that personal. But
and you talked about that a little bit on your website, too, right? Yeah. And how, and that is heartfelt, too, because, you know, now as an adult, you know, what happened, you know, this was, when you were there, you felt like it was a good school. But I'm sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off.
No, you're right.
Elaborate.
Like, I went to Robert Fulton Elementary School, closed.
Mm-hmm.
I went to Pickett Middle School, Well, Pick is not really, it's closed, but it's not closed because they got a charter school that uses one half of the school, okay, and the other half isn't used. When I was there,
okay,
the whole school was used. We had houses, red house, green house, blue, okay, house. We had houses. So that's closed. And then my alma mater, my high school, Germantown High School, is closed. And Germantown been around for, my father graduated from Germantown. My aunt graduated
That's generational.
Brother, cousin, you know, like, you know, it's bloodline in that school, and then they closed it. So, you know, I struggled with that, but, you know, life goes on. You know, my goal is honestly to put myself in a position financially to go back and buy Germantown High School and turn it into a preparation school for boys to teach them entrepreneurship, leadership skills, you know, how to treat women, how to think outside of the box, thinkers, a think tank. How to become, you know, productive to society, but to make a difference in their own community. So that's my goal too. That's the thing I wrote on my God list, to go back and buy Germantown High School and turn it into something.
And you'll do it.
Yeah, hey.
You know, I mean, because you're already on the path. You already got the background, the foundation, the finance, the understanding of that. So
I'm too dark to blush. Don't make me blush, man.
So family, tell a little bit more about your family.
My father's deceased. My mother's here. My mom's side of the family is here. Between, you know, Mount Airy, Germantown, back Brickyard, and the Hollow, and back up this way. So, the majority of my family, both sides, is here in Philadelphia, and some over in Jersey, in the Camden. But the core of us, we come from the Germantown, Haines Street, Shelton area, Shelton area.
Okay. All right. So now that we talked, and you touched on this a little bit too about why you're doing this type of work. But what was your original? What was it, a person or your original feelings about it? What inspired you to get into this line of work? I mean, first, let's talk about the banking side of it first. What inspired you to get into banking originally?
Oops, I'm in banking. Fact? No, it was funny. I used to live in D.C. I lived in D.C. Mm-hmm. When I came home from college, I moved back to D.C. because I thought at the end of the day I wouldn't be in Philadelphia, which I still think at the end of the day, when it's all said and done, I probably won't be.
Okay.
Permanently in Philadelphia, but I moved to D.C. Mm-hmm. And I was there from 99 to 2003. I was down there for the sniper, 9/11. I was down there for all that.
Oh wow!
I came back to Philly. I was working for Enterprise Rent a Car because I was working for them down there.
Okay.
When I came back, I was a manager down there. When I came back to Philly, they kind of was like pimping me. They didn't give me back a management status, but was using me in a management capacity.
I
got frustrated. I was young, high-headed, and I was like, man, I'm not doing this.
Right.
So a good friend of mine, Montez Hill, he actually plugged me into another good friend of mine named Aaliyah, that worked for Wachovia Bank at the time.
Okay.
She was like, you know, go apply, whatever I did.
Okay.
I went an interview probably like the following week. Okay. And I interviewed, left, went to go meet with her and tell her about it. And as we sitting in lunch, they called me and offered me the job.
Nice.
And she was like, that's the first time I've ever seen them hire anybody that quick. You know?
You went in sharp.
I ain't had to go and do my thing, right? So it was, I believe in life that we don't just happen to end up places. We happen to be places where God wants us.
Yes. Yes.
You know, and I think that
I agree 100%.
You know, and I think that I got put into banking because that was the path God needed me to go.
Okay.
To take me to the path where he has me going.
Okay.
Right? And so where I think I'm going is bipartisan of where I came from, of the lessons I learned from being in banking and seeing the disparities of understanding the basic principles of basic banking, checking, savings. Mm-hmm. Pay ourselves, build up the account, how the bank's going to approach you when you build up that account, and just teaching people those lessons. And like I said, with me trying to create this movement of for 2016, you know, why not prosper? Put your bank card away and keep cash in your pocket.
Right.
You know, give the banks less money and keep more money.
So it sounds like, in a sense, that the banking, the path taken there led you right into your inspirational side. in terms of educating others. Share a little, talk a little bit more about that. I mean,
no, I think you did on with that. Mm-hmm. And when I think about it, I did tell you a funny story. One, when I was growing up, my grandmother was a pastor, so I was in church Monday, Tuesday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday for 20 hours. Okay. And my mom used to say was really a good singer, and she would sing in church a lot. Okay. Long story short, my grandma was a pastor. My grandma used to always say, "You got a calling on your life." She used to say it to me all the time. "You got a calling on your life." I think, God rest her soul, I think what she was saying was my calling is what I'm walking into.
Okay.
With this inspirational speaking. Okay. Funny part about it is I've been speaking off and on for a while. A few years back, probably 2005, 2006, I was asked to go to, it's a church right on Broadway. I can't think of the name of it right now. They got their own thing. Long story short, I was asked to go speak at this church. Mm-hmm. I go there on a Sunday. It's a Sunday.
Okay.
Everybody's suited and booted.
Okay.
I walk into the church, and the gentleman looks at me, and he says, "You're the speaker, aren't you?" I'm like, "What?"
Right.
He said, "You're the speaker." Mm-hmm. I said, "How do you know that?"
Right.
He said, "I could just tell." Mm-hmm. I said, "Everybody in here dressed the same. How do you know?" He said, "I could tell."
Right? Okay. It's the way you walk in, you carry
it. It was crazy.
That's it. Yeah.
So I spoke in there, talking about, you know, banking and different things. And when I got done, another older gentleman walked up to me. He said, "You know what, young man? As I watched you up there speaking, you remind me of Les Brown to the T." So I didn't even know who Les Brown was at that time.
Right.
I was like, "What? But thank you." I didn't know, right?
Right. Just take the
compliment.
Right.
But I ran home and ran on Google, looked him up, like, and I was humbled. I was humbled on so many levels. I was like, first of all, to even be compared to this man is like great, right? To even be compared in the same lane as him of something I don't even realize that I'm supposed to be doing.
Right.
Was like awesome. And then to read his bio and to read like some of the similarities of his life and my life, and I'm like, this is crazy. And I just didn't think twice about it after that. And then now it's just kind of been coming back for me to, you know, do it. And I enjoy inspiring people. When I get up there to speak to people, I'm giving you everything I have in my soul. So when I'm done, you've gotten everything.
Right.
For me.
And you leave it with that inspiration as you spoke to you. A few minutes ago, and that's wonderful. And I must commend, I mean, I hear you speaking to your faith, and I'm 100% with that. We feel the same way. I mean, nothing we do is done alone.
Nothing.
Nothing we do. We speak to that. We believe in that wholeheartedly. Speaking of who we are in terms of what No Notes is, you know, nothing we do comes, we don't do it by ourselves. And that's just wonderful to know that God is in control and making things happen for us, man. And that's a wonderful thing. I just wanted to take a moment to
speak
to that.
Speak
to that.
Listen, anybody who feels that they can maneuver, and it's funny because when I speak, what I usually say when I speak is I say the universe. I won't say God. And so I remember speaking to a young man at the bank when I was at the bank one time, and I said universe, and his mom said, "Well, why do you say universe?" I said, "Let me tell you why I say universe. Because I think at the end of the day, God is the universe and universe is God. Now, whatever you decide to label your deity is your business."
Right.
Right? If you call him Jesus Christ, you call him Allah, you call him Buddha, whatever you call him, you know that there is a deity higher than you.
Right.
Right? And to me, that's all that matters.
Yes.
Right? And so I don't have to worry about offending anyone by saying a particular name, right? Not that that's a big thing for me, but I just feel like if I can make you comfortable to get the message, then get the message.
Right.
Right? But I can take you out the pocket if you feel like something different, right?
Right.
So, but if I say the universe, everybody got to accept the universe because the universe is all being, all knowing, right? And
it's
all being and all knowing is not you or I. Is he.
Yes.
Amen. So that's why I speak to it in, from that perspective of knowing that I know without everything I've been through in life and where I've gone and where I'm going, without God, I would be or have nothing.
Right. Amen. Amen. So tell us, a little bit more about, you have a website. A lot of the website I spoke when we first started is great. We're going, before we close out, we're going to make sure you have all of Rich's information, you know, check out the website. But so, tell us about a little bit about the website.
The website is my way of people being able to book me, learn a little bit about me, keep up on what I got going on, and to follow my social media. So my Twitter feeds come through there.
Okay.
You can see the links to go to my Facebook pages, my Gmail, and everything is on there. So you can have access to me about that. I am very about anything about positivity, upliftment is me. What you won't do is go on my social media and find anything with negativity connected to it, associated with it in any shape, fashion, or form. But you get a little taste of me, not all my personal life, but you get a little taste of who I am as a person, you know? And that's what I try to make sure I play. And with the website, I think it gives access to read a little bit more about me, but also be able to go on and book me and read, some of the things people have already said about me.
Yes. Right. Yep. And their video clips on there, very informative. And inspirational. Check those out as well. I just want to not to get too much off subject before we get ready to close out. You're also part of a wonderful group on Facebook, Boys and Men in Business.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Boys and Men in Business.
Talk about that a little bit. No Notes is associated with Boys and Men in Business as well, but
A young lady by the name of Leslie grew up, and she created Boys the Men in Business, and basically what her thought was for a platform for men to come together, galvanize, work together, and create something that's going to be a movement for us.
Yes.
And so it's a platform for men to come in, you know, connect with other men, not really just to advertise your business, but to build and cultivate relationships.
Right.
I think one of the biggest mistakes we make is we don't really connect and cultivate relationships. Somebody asked me one day, like, why you call yourself Mr. PDQ? And I said,
yes, please reflect on that. We were getting to that next, but go ahead. Yes.
PDQ has a sentimental value to me. PDQ was my father's nickname. They called my father PDQ and everything, and they actually called me Little Q or Daddy Rich when I was growing up.
Okay.
My father passed away. Prior to the following year, I bought a house, and I had a thing where his name kept popping up on me. It kept bothering me, and so I put it up there. And what it has turned into is me taking on his name, me making it my brand, creating a company called People Demand Quality LLC, which I work with small businesses, helping them through the banking process, and then Mr. PDQ, the inspirational speaker as well.
Yes.
And ultimately, once I get these two things where I want to get them, then I want to create a nonprofit called Pennies, Dimes, and Quarters. And that's going to be strictly to work for kids, with kids, about kids, with nothing but understanding money.
Okay.
And with Boys and Men, those are the type of things that you can go into that group and put your ideals out there and connect with some people.
This is how we got connected, you know, because we're a part of this fantastic group. You know, here's the networking that is produced.
Yep.
And before I close out, I'm gonna get into that a little more. This is not the end.
Yeah.
You know, we, as you always know, for our fans out there, our audiences, we always say, you know, once we connect with somebody, it's not just that one time. And then you never hear from them again. We stay with you. We're going to stay connected. We're going to follow you. You know, we're going. It's that business dynamic, business for business dynamic. That's what it's about. You know, supporting each other, which we both spoke on already. But it continues on. I mean, because you just don't want to hear about somebody one time, and then that's it. And then, you know, you say, well, what happened to that person? We keep it going.
My goal. This time next year is to be traveling the country. My goal is to travel the country, but to not only do that, to reach back and you and I connect and we doing an interview, you know, if it's Skype where I get to come back in the city, we do it person to person. But now I get to put you out in front of some more people that might not have known about you. Now I need y'all to see this clip because this is my people. Oh, the no-no show. Yep. Great people to connect with. I'm all about supporting us, pushing us out there, putting it out there. I help people on my page. So you got something going on, I put it on my page too as well. Because I feel like you have to be a giver. You have to be one that's willing to give. And you have to be one that has a pleasing personality to engage people.
Right.
And I think those are some of the key things that you have to success to become a business person. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
And work properly.
Exactly. Now, with saying that, before we come to our conclusion, please tell us how people out there, our audience, everybody that's going to be seeing this, listening to us, as always, how can they connect with you? Please give them your information, all the contact numbers, the email, the social media, you can run through it. Make sure, because we want you guys to come and connect with this young man here. I mean, you hear what he's about. And we all can use advice on finance. We all can use some inspirational words, you know, in our daily lives. Hit it.
Well, you can reach me. My website is www.pdqmanagement.com. So you can reach. You can go there to book me or look up what I got going on. You know, what's the last few things that I've done? You can look into some testimonials on there as well. So it tells a little bit about my story. On social media, you type in Mr. PDQ on Facebook, on Instagram, Twitter, I usually pop back up. On Facebook, you type in Mr.PDQ, I'll come right up with no problem. On Twitter, it's Mr_PDQ. And on Instagram, it's Mr.PDQ_. So you can find me on all those. My email address, if you wanted to email me, is PDQ@PDQmanagement.com. Once again, the website is www.pdqmanagement.com.
Okay, great. And along with that, we asked Richard to share this, but it also will be spelled out through this feed, through this video, and along with all of No Notes social venues. You know, so there's no reason why you can't reach out to him. The information is going to be out there. Take the opportunity. Come, you know, get to know this young man. With that, before we go. Now, we're in December. What do you have? And this is also, he has an events lineup on his website. You can see what's coming up. Mm-hmm. Just share a little bit for, you know, what's coming up the rest of December. What's coming up in January? What do you have going on?
Right now, I just finished talking to my aunt. She wants me to come speak, but that's not until May or March. She's having a woman's thing at her church, and she wants me to come speak to them on that, so I'm looking forward to that. But my biggest focus right now, to be honest with you, I'm trying to get 1,000 black men together.
Okay.
And so here's my goal. I need 10 men to step up and get in contact with me, and they'll be my point of contact. I deal with those 10 men, and I need those 10 men to ultimately be able to gather 100 men behind them. Okay. And what I want to do is show, first off, what our power, our presence and our impact is from us just being present. Okay. So what I want to do is for us to, when the kids come back from school after the Christmas break, I want to be up at Martin Luther King High School here in Philadelphia at about 6:45, lined up, all of us suited and booted, and with brown bags with some fruit, a sandwich, something to drink, something nutritious for the kids to start their day, and to be able to hand those kids a brown bag to start their day as they go in and start school. I'm thinking about what the impact is as a young black male or young black female. I'm walking up to school and I see 1,000 black men lined up in front of my school, right? Handing me something that's going to be nourishing to start my day, to start my level of education. And whatever that snowballs into afterwards, that's what it'll let it do that.
Right.
but I just want to show that if we as black men, not boys, if black men step up, we can truly impact our communities on a whole nother level. right? So think about it like this. If a cop came into our community and did something to harm, hurt, or endanger or kill one of our boys, right? What you going to do if 1,000 black men show up at the district? What you going to do? Nonviolent. We showing up and we saying we're not moving until y'all fix this situation, get rid of them, fire the person that did what they did, and y'all need to give us a public apology about what happened. How powerful was that, and we could take back our community. So I feel like if I can get galvanized some positive, forward-thinking black men that's willing to move and not be on social media running their mouth, just talking about the shoulda, coulda, wouldas, and feeding the negativity. Because as long as we feed the negativity, that's all we want to breathe. Right? I'm conscious of what I put in my system when I wake up in the morning.
Right.
I listen to positive stuff.
Right.
I start my day off with something positive. Prayer, meditation, and something positive. Right. So that's what I think that, you know, we have to be able to teach these young boys. A lot of them, they just want somebody to show them how to be men. They just want somebody to be able to talk to and say, hey, how do I do this?
Yeah.
Right?
Sure. So, a mentor, someone to guide them right in the right direction.
That's it.
Yes.
How much of that going to take out of your life?
Right.
Right? Because once again, you know, I spoke at the women's reentry program, and what I spoke about was your dash, right? You know, in life, when we come in the world 19 whatever, and we may die 2000 or whatever, right? Mm-hmm. But that means nothing. Mm-hmm. What did you do with your dash? What did you do with your time here? Mm-hmm. How many lives have you impacted? How many lives have you changed? What did you do to be a betterment to the society in which you live in?
Right.
And that's my goal. If I can change the mindsets and some men to do that, I feel like we can create a movement. You know, so imagine if you got 1,000 black men on this side of the city of Philadelphia, 1,000 black men in West Philadelphia, in Southwest Philadelphia, 1,000 black men in South Philadelphia. All right, so just in the pockets from the Germantown, Mount Airy, West Oak Lane area, North Philly, Southwest and South Philly, that's over 3,000 black men.
Yeah.
What could we do?
Sky's the limit, right?
Sky's the limit. The movement is powerful.
Yes.
So I just want to be able to, that's just my goal right now, to try to contact, you know, 10 black men. And listen, if you are serious about what I'm talking about, and you really want to step up and not be just talking about the problem, be a part of the solution and help me with this, you can contact me at 267-495-8537. That's 267-495-8537. Or you can hit me on Facebook or on my website, you know what I'm saying, or email me. Y'all need my email.
Again, you know, no excuses. All this information that you're hearing is also going to be nicely displayed. It's going through the feed, you know. It's going to be on No Notes channels. So, you know, don't hesitate. You can count No Notes in.
No,
we're all about the positive. Strength in numbers, strengthening our communities. Supporting our
y'all see that, right?
Yep.
So look, I'm holding to this. So I'm holding.
I need you to
get me 100 brothers that's going to follow, that we commit to you to show up for that day. So you'll be my point of contact. And then, because what I want to do, once I got all 10 brothers, what I want to do is just have a conference call, and then we update and everything. And then my other goal is I'm going to go find a black restaurant. To have to see if they'll be willing to do the breakfast for us, right?
Okay.
And what I want to do is get all the brothers to put up, like, every brother put up like $10 or $20 or whatever, right? Okay. For the meal for the kids.
Right.
And then we take that money, so it's twofold. So not only do we support our kids, but now we've supported a black business that's in our community.
Mm-hmm.
So if each brother give up $10 or $20, and that's nothing, you spend that in a day on BS,
one day, right?
So
junk food.
So if a brother give up $20, each brother give up $20, we going to then in turn take that money and give it to the restaurant that decided to help us with this project, and that's their money for their contribution of supporting us in that move.
And you know what? Also, you just built a relationship with that restaurant. There you go. So for future events,
that's my
see
point.
How that works?
That's
yeah,
my
it's
point.
Networking, baby.
That's what it's
that's
about.
That's it. So. Again, thank you for taking the time out of your busy schedule.
They keep saying thank you. No. Let's be clear. Right?
You gotta say thank you to the guests.
No.
You got to.
Listen, good brother, you are giving me a platform that I would not have if you not afforded me the opportunity to be on your platform, which you do greatly. You are very adamant and passionate about what you do, when you do it. You're professional with your business. Even today, we got here, you was here on time. We met up on time. We wasn't here at 6:05, 6:15. We was on time when we handled business, right? And to me, the more we are doing that, the better we are as businessmen. Right? Yes. And so I want to thank you for saying that you was even, that I'm even warranted the opportunity to be on your show, to connect with your people, to say thank you. So I want to say to you, thank you for letting me do that. I'm humble.
We certainly appreciate that. We certainly appreciate that. And again, this is not the last time you're going to see Mr. PDQ on our show. And you, we want you to get involved with this event. You already, No Notes has already committed to it. We're down with this. We're going to be there. Positivity, strength in numbers, strength in our community, strength in the world. I mean, that's what we're about. You know what we're about.
I just had a moment, though. Had a moment.
Before we do this,
you guys are supporting it, then you guys can record it so we can then reboot it on the No Notes show.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
We ain't worrying about Fox 29 or none of that. We ain't worrying about, I don't care about none of that. So we can do it. You do this. We record it, and we put it back on your show. Yes. So now that's all business coming back to you, because people see that you produced it, you did it, and so that's another way that now we're keeping it in
the circle.
In the circle.
There you go. There you go. Well, with that being said, you know, all great things come to an end. Another great show. We know that you will enjoy this one as always, and we thank you so much for your support. You know how to reach us. You can send us an email to nonoshow@all.com. You can give us a call, 610-626-0454. Check us out on our website, www.thenonoshow.com. You know where we are on social media, too. Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, WordPress, SoundCloud. And now, Pinterest.
We just added Pinterest.
So, you know, we try in terms of social media. There's so much out there to get involved in. But we try to keep it minimal or under what we can control. So that's why somebody said one time, well, how come you're not on Instagram? Because
it don't fit you.
Yeah, right. You gotta know what fits you. Exactly.
Stay
in
your lane.
Right. And we don't do just pictures. So that, I mean, and that's a great platform for all pictures, but we do a little more than that. But you know, maybe one day, who's to say? You know, maybe we'll pop up on Instagram too. Who knows?
Oh, and but one thing, if I don't want
to. Go ahead.
If you can go subscribe to my YouTube channel, if you type in Mr. PDQ, my YouTube channel will come up. It's not a lot of videos there now, but I'm about to start being on there. I'm going to put up a video every Saturday, is going to be my goal. And my mantra for December going into the new year is why not prosper. So I'm trying to see, figure out why not prosper. What are you willing to sacrifice to prosper? Let's prosper.
And we'll make sure we connect with you on YouTube as well.
All right.
With that being said, we'll see you. We thank you for your support. We're looking forward to hearing from you, and we truly hope that you do. You know, getting ready for a new year. You know, you already heard about the event. It's going to be a great thing. Please come and join us. And just the more the merrier, more to be continued. I don't know. Should I say thank you? I mean, he didn't want me to say
no,
thank you.
Because let me tell you, gratitude is something we don't do enough of. And I want to show gratitude to anyone that's willing to pour into me. You're pouring into me by giving me this opportunity to some people that I've never met, but they know who you are.
Right.
So I should be thanking you. You should be thanking me. That's just my opinion.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
All right. We'll take that. We'll see you next time for another great episode of No Show. Thanks for joining us.